In 1945, two atomic bombs were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, killing 50,000 people each and unleashing 20 kilotons of TNT. These were the only nuclear bombs ever used against civilian populations, but the ensuing arms race would see the United States and Soviet Union developing ever more powerful weapons of mass destruction. The culmination of this work was the Tsar Bomba, the most powerful nuclear bomb ever detonated, with an explosive force of 50 megatons of TNT. That's 50 million tons of TNT, and 10 times more powerful than every bomb and bullet used during World War II combined. The bombs dropped on Japan decimated entire cities, but the Tsar Bomba is 1,570 times more powerful. Since World War II, cities have only become denser and more populated, so it's worth asking, what would an explosion of that size do to some of today's largest cities? In its original testing, the Tsar Bomba was detonated at 11:52 Moscow time over Novaya Zemlya Island. In a flash, the bomb created a fireball 5 miles wide that could be seen from 600 miles away. The bomb's mushroom cloud soared to 40 miles high, nearly touching the edge of space, with its cap spreading outwards until it stretched nearly 63 miles from end to end. Just as a size comparison, for my American viewers, that's an area larger than Delaware. And for my international viewers, that's an area just a little smaller than American Eagles. A village on the island 34 miles away was completely destroyed. Shockwaves shook buildings and blew out windows at the Dixon settlement 400 miles away. And because of atmospheric focusing, the blast was able to damage windows as far as Norway and Finland. And the blast wave through the atmosphere was so strong, it hit sensors nearby, wrapped around the Earth, hit them again, wrapped around the Earth, hit them again, then wrapped around the Earth and hit the sensors one more time. But enough background on the bomb, let's get to blowing up some cities. Like King Kong, first we'll focus on New York City. What if the Tsar Bomba was detonated above the streets of the Big Apple? Anyone within 3 kilometers would receive an instantly lethal dose of radiation. Although that wouldn't matter much, because anyone within a 4.5 kilometer range would be consumed in a nuclear fireball. Going out as far as 9 kilometers, the force of the blast would be so intense that virtually every building would be demolished within a fraction of a second. More than 3 million people live in this area alone. And for comparison, remember, the bombs dropped in Japan only killed 50,000 people each. Going out to 21 kilometers, buildings, trees, and even clothing would quickly catch on fire from intense ionizing radiation, leaving most people severely injured. As far out as 54 kilometers, all windows would be shattered. And given the shockwave moves at the speed of sound, but the flash moves at the speed of light, people would see the flash of the bomb nearly 2 minutes before the shockwave got to them. And because humans love staring straight at danger, this means up to 12 million people could be looking out the window at the fiery explosion when the glass comes shattering in from the shockwave. And if you were unlucky enough to be outside when the bomb went off, as far as 60 kilometers away, you could expect third-degree burns from the heat of the blast. All told, just in the immediate aftermath of the blast, you'd be looking at more than 7.5 million dead and more than 4 million critically injured. But the majority of those 4 million would likely pass away. Those 4 million critically injured people are 16 times more than the total hospital capacity across the US. And that's before thinking about the people with more minor injuries, like cuts and broken bones. Without immediate treatment, many of those people would succumb to infections from their wounds. The casualties from just this one bomb would be 7 times more than the deaths of every US service member in every war combined. And remember, America has fought in a lot of wars. Luckily for New Yorkers, by land area, more of New Jersey would actually be destroyed than New York. Radioactive particles would linger in the air, but surprisingly, radioactive fallout isn't as much of a concern as you might think. Radioactive particles from the blast would quickly decay. 7 hours after the blast, residual radioactivity would have fallen by more than 90%. By 48 hours, it would be less than 1%. Still a problem for anyone seeking immediate medical attention, but most survivors could avoid the radiation camping out in their homes. So the only people in real danger are those immediately upwind of the blast, mostly all across Connecticut. Blasts across major cities would have similar disastrous effects. Moscow, nearly 10 million dead. Paris, 8. Tokyo, with one of the highest population densities in the world, 16 million people. And Hawaii? Well, let's just say we'd be back to 49 states. But that's if you detonated the bomb above a city. What if it was underground? Well, that really depends on how deep you bury it. Bury a body 6 feet deep and it won't be found. Bury the Tsar Bomba 6 feet underground and it's like you did nothing. If the bomb isn't deep enough, you'll be left with a crater and radiation shot into the atmosphere. The exact distance you need to bury a nuclear bomb depends on the rock it's buried in, but generally speaking, to contain the explosion, the burial depth in meters divided by the cube root of the yield in kilotons needs to be at least 100.
Boy, everyone is stupid except me.
The Tsar Bomba had an explosive force of 50,000 kilotons, so plugging that into our equation means the world's most powerful bomb would have to be buried at least 3,684 meters, or 2.3 miles. The only man-made hole ever dug that deep was the Kola Super Deep Borehole in Russia, stretching 7.5 miles into the Earth, but it was only 9 inches in diameter, so you won't be fitting a bomb down there anytime soon. The energy of the nuclear explosion is released in 1 microsecond, with temperatures of several million degrees and pressures of several million atmospheres. Within milliseconds of exploding, a bubble of high-pressure gas and steam would form, vaporizing the surrounding rock. The explosion would create a cavity in the rock, 1.2 kilometers or 3/4 of a mile across. The Limited Test Ban Treaty, signed between the United States, Soviet Union, United Kingdom, and eventually 105 other countries, banned nuclear testing in the atmosphere, space, and underwater, but specifically excluded underground tests from the list, because the Soviet Union feared this would necessitate on-site inspections to investigate, and they didn't want Americans peeking their head around Soviet nuclear facilities. As of today, the largest underground nuclear explosion was Project Kanakin by the United States. On November 6, 1971, a 5-megaton bomb was detonated along the Aleutian Islands, Alaska's long tail of island chains. This is within the 20 biggest nuclear devices ever detonated, but the Tsar Bomba would still be 10 times more powerful. And the go-to question everyone always asks, what if we detonated the bomb in space? Well, in space, the physics of nuclear weapons changes drastically. First, in the absence of an atmosphere, the blast disappears completely. Second, thermal radiation that caused everything to light up here on Earth also disappears. There's no longer any air for the blast wave to heat, and so the weapon emits a much higher frequency of radiation. Third, and most importantly, here on Earth, the atmosphere dulls explosions. Think about trying to scream to someone underwater. Sure, it's possible for them to hear you, but they have to be a lot closer than they would be outside the pool. The atmosphere dampens the explosive force, but without it in space, the range of a nuclear explosion would be 10 to 30 times larger. While the bomb released lethal radiation for 37 miles on Earth, in space, that would be more than 600 miles or 1,000 kilometers. There aren't many people in space, but this would have effects across the globe. One of the most noticeable here on the ground, ribbons of light would dance across the night sky. Think of northern lights for days, as radiation from the blast reacts with the Earth's magnetic field. On July 6, 1962, the United States detonated a 1.4 megaton nuclear bomb in space above Johnson Atoll in the Pacific. The goal was to study the effects of nuclear explosions in space, because why run simulations when you can do the real thing, am I right? The explosion, only 3% as strong as the Tsar Bomba, generated an aurora for 1,000 miles. Hawaii, 9 miles away, suffered a complete power outage, and satellites were damaged tens of miles away. The explosion destroyed 6 satellites, but in 1962, there were only about 250 satellites in space. Today, there are more than 6,000 orbiting the Earth. An explosion the size of the Tsar Bomba would destroy hundreds of satellites. And besides being able to cripple an entire country, when it takes down Netflix, it would force some of you to actually go outside. But don't worry too much. It's been more than 50 years since a nuclear device was detonated in space. Want to change that? Well, check out our video on how to build an at-home nuclear bomb. And remember, there's always more to learn.